all the modern technology, TV, social media today, especially within the younger generation, we can get really distracted from what's really important in our lives, like our families, our religions, our individual faiths, our values. And within the Amish and Mennonite community, they dedicate themselves to these aspects of their lives. And we have found, talking to people here, living a day in the Amish and Mennonite community, that those are the things that truly lead to a happy life. Of how the Amish came to be in the United States. They were a part of the Puritan group that came over in the 1600s trying to separate from the Roman Catholic Church. And then during the Protestant Reformation, the Anabaptists, a group within the Puritans, they separated because they wanted a separation of church and state. And out of the Anabaptists formed the beliefs of the Amish.
The Mennonites, we accept the modern conveniences. But the basic thing of Amish and Mennonites, what we believe the same is that we're all born sinners and it's only through Jesus and his blood that we're saved.
What do you think of when you think of Amish?
I think of old bearded men. Yeah. I think that the Amish are very secluded and that, I mean, maybe they're not mean, it's just like they're not the most approachable people all the time just because they're like, I don't know, where even is Amish country? Like who knows where the Amish live? Like, yeah. I don't know.
There are a lot of misconceptions about the Amish. Many people are intimidated by their isolation, their modest clothing, and their strong religious beliefs. Even we thought that it would be hard to find people that would be willing and friendly and wanting to talk to us. However, when we did talk to them, they were really kind and we were very well received. They even told us that they don't think that people who don't choose to live their lifestyle are living their life in the wrong or living it completely unfaithfully. They just want to live their own lives and focus on their own values.
I don't know, the Amish probably don't even know about 9/11, Kim Kardashian, Justin Bieber, Drake Bell, or Josh Peck, which is really sad.
Montezuma, Georgia. We're going to visit the Amish.
We're going to try and interview some people there in the community and try their food and just explore.
We're excited.
Yep, it should be fun.
Our project and our findings here would be something that would be a negative aspect of the Amish and Mennonite churches, but while talking to the people, we realized that they really have values that I think that we all agree that we want to strive to be more like.
So the first person that we met today, her name was Carmen, and she worked at Kaufman's Strawberry Farm. She was the daughter of the non-denominational Mennonite church pastor, and she was very interesting to talk to because she was like 17 or 18 years old, and she seemed very hardworking and dedicated to her faith.
After talking to many people in the community, we learned that the teens are really happy and content with the lifestyle that they live and thankful for the values that their parents taught them. If they had the choice to leave, many of them would choose to stay, just like Carmen.
So today, after a long journey of trying to find men to fit into our documentary, we finally found them in the restaurant, and they were with their entire family. And that was cute how they were demonstrating the family pact.
I'm Flores Yoder. I'm Paul Cattle Party. Mm-hmm.
So Yoder, that's a common name around here, right?
Yeah. And this is my son.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's my daughter, granddaughter, great-granddaughter, great-grandson.
What I love about our culture is that we are very family-oriented. Our families are very much together. Community is important to us. Our church, helping one another. When I think of my church, I think of as a big family.
Something that we noticed while we were in Montezuma is that the community really revolves around the church, and everyone is a really close-knit group. If you ever need anything, there's always somebody you can go ask, and here, you know, we can walk around town and not know half the people that we see. And we think that it's really important to have that strong community because it grounds you.
Although the education in the Amish and Mennonite community is not the best, and the communities tend to be quite isolated, they choose to educate their children through 8th grade so that the children can help the family on the farms, and they choose to isolate themselves in order to avoid any temptations or societal pressures.
Having kids leave school after the 8th grade to come work in the family business helps them develop hardworking skills, and it also brings the families closer together.
We're from New Oxford, Pennsylvania. We've been raising turkeys here for about 19 years. We love what we're doing. Some people go to work, sit behind a desk. Some people fight a lot of traffic. Out here, this is normal for us. This is our occupation. This is our way of life. We enjoy it. It's family oriented. All of our 9 children know what it is to be in the turkey house, to work. They enjoy the principles of work and work ethics and being around the family unit. And the turkeys allow us to do that.
Being born and raised in our culture is a privilege that I treasure, because we're taught many things from little up that many people aren't.
And everybody faces the same temptations in their everyday life. The Amish and the Mennonites face many of the same temptations that we do. For example, technology, social media, sex, drugs, and alcohol. They are all things that play a part in their lives, just like they do in ours. And the Amish Mennonites really pride themselves in their ability to resist these temptations and focus on their values.
Like, we could be exposed as much as we allow ourselves, because we have,
You have an iPhone.
Yes, we have everything. Okay. We have internet, we have the news, you know, everything. So it actually, for us, we can be exposed to a lot, and I would say it's good for us because that tests us, helps us to be stronger where we stand. We're just as human as anyone. Mm-hmm. We face just as many temptations mm-hmm. as anyone. And it's just, I think the stress is the everyday battle of just staying faithful.
Very good, yeah.
I would say is just as big
universal.
For us as, yeah.
So ultimately, what we can take away from today is that there are often misconceptions about the Amish and the Mennonites, that they are condescending and not accepting of others, and that their lifestyle involves no technology at all. However, today we have received so much like kind reception, and everyone was so welcoming.
As the world around us advances, technology has played an increased role in our everyday lives. It consumes us to the point where it seems as though it would be impossible to live without it.
The Amish and Mennonites have chosen to remove these distractions from their lives in order to prioritize their fundamental values, commitment to their faith and family. Through our research and our experience in the Mennonite community of Montezuma, Georgia, we have discovered that the Amish and the Mennonites have a better grasp on the components of a happy, faithful lifestyle than most of us do.
Therefore, we encourage the incorporation of their fundamental values in moderation into our everyday lives. Whether you're Christian, Hindu, atheist, or whatever beliefs you follow, you can take away one valuable lesson from the Amish and the Mennonites. That is, dedication to your beliefs, even when the rest of the world does not see things the exact same way that you do.
So put down your phone.
Don't let media influence you.
Give your family a hug.
Stand by your beliefs.
And be happy with the way you choose to lead your life.
Sorry.
Okay.
Hey, I can't talk right now. Yeah? No, I'm in Amish country.